What's going on, guys? Do me a favor, hit that like, subscribe, share, and that thumbs up. I sure appreciate it. As well as that notification bell. Hit that notification bell. It will notify you every time I put out a new content. Sorry to everybody. I haven't been on here in a while. Been having issues with my phone. Hopefully, I got that took care of. Tennessee versus Georgia in Sanford Stadium. Number one against number two. I'm going to say this. Georgia, if they play like they did the third quarter against Tennessee, like they did against Florida, Georgia's going to have major issues. And I'm going to tell everybody right now, Georgia's cornerbacks and safeties better be on their A game come Saturday afternoon at 3:30. Tennessee, and I don't know his name, but I sure know his number, number 11. If them safeties and them cornerbacks are not on their A game, that guy is going to burn them all day long. Now, in order for Georgia to win this game, and this is going to be a fight for Georgia, I'm not going to put no ifs, ands, or buts on it. And as a true Georgia fan speaking, this is going to be a major test for Georgia Saturday. The biggest game Georgia has played this season. And this will determine the rest of the season. This is for the SEC championship, who goes to the national championship. And I can tell you, if Kirby Smart and this coaching staff don't have these players ready and prepared, it's going to be a long Saturday for the Bulldogs. Like Florida, Georgia's defense has to get to Hendon Hooker. We have to pressure him as much as we can. We cannot let him out of the pocket. And we can't have 17 penalties like Alabama did against Tennessee. We are going to have to go into this game without penalties. Now, I'm not saying we're not going to have none. But we can't go into this game and start getting penalties on us. Georgia is going to have to play a smart game. And let's hope Todd Monken and Kirby Smart, like they do in every game, try these screen passes. Because the screen passes don't work. Stetson Bennett cannot turn the ball over against Tennessee. Now, luckily, it was just Florida we was playing. We had three turnovers, two interceptions, and a fumble. Stetson Bennett is going to have to play smart with the football. Don't throw it into double coverage. And if the play ain't there, then throw it away. Go to the next down. Tennessee is better than Florida. Yes, we could have turnovers against Florida. Their offense isn't great. They wasn't a come-from-behind team. Tennessee is. The advantage Georgia will have in this game is we're playing at home. So hopefully the home crowd can make that stadium loud to where it disrupts Tennessee's offense. Maybe they'll disrupt them enough they'll get false starts and keep backing up. But I will tell you, Georgia better be on their A game come Saturday. And I said it at the beginning of the season, Tennessee wasn't going to be no pushover this year. Tennessee was the team that I was worried the most about this year than South Carolina, Florida, Kentucky. Their coach has turned that program around. And this isn't but his second season. Well, I will tell you, this team will be ready to play. They will be pumped up and energized. They will be fired up. And the crowd will be fired up. And yes, I'm talking about the Dogs. I'm sure Tennessee's going to be pumped too. But I can tell you, if our cornerbacks let these receivers behind them, then Georgia might be in trouble. We have to keep these receivers in front of us. And God knows when the ball is thrown, will these defend our cornerbacks? Will they turn around and look for the ball so they can either knock it down or intercept the ball? All season, Georgia's cornerbacks, they face guard their opponent's receivers instead of turning around looking for the ball so they could intercept it or knock it away. They face guard. Then they get called for a penalty. We got to slow their running game down. Can we control their running backs? We had two really good linebackers in Mondon and Johnson who can run from sideline to sideline. Can we contain them? Now, Georgia's offense, like I said, Bennett's got to play smart football. We cannot turn the ball over against this Tennessee offense, or we can't turn the ball over and give it to Tennessee's offense. So Stetson Bennett is going to have to be smart with the football. Now, can our running game continue to play like they played the last few games? Can our offensive line hold up against Tennessee's defensive line? Let's hope the offensive line coach has some tricks up his sleeves to where we can open up holes for these running backs. This game might come down to the fourth quarter, last team with the ball. Let's hope not. Let's hope Georgia can put this game away in two quarters. One quarter. Maybe they can go ahead and put this game away first quarter. If not first quarter, maybe second quarter. But we cannot, and I repeat, we cannot come out and play good the first half and then second half play sloppy. Georgia needs to come out and play from first quarter to fourth quarter with no mistakes. They need to play great football first quarter to fourth quarter. Not this play good this quarter, play bad that quarter. Play good this quarter, play bad this quarter. So hopefully during this week, Kirby Smart and his coaching staff has prepared these players and has come up with a perfect game plan to beat Tennessee. Let's hope they've studied enough film on Tennessee to be able to take care of them. This is all or nothing for Georgia. I believe if Georgia loses this game, their season is done. Let's hope that ain't the case. But once again, we can't go in and have 17 penalties against Tennessee. We have to try to go in and play this game penalty free. Will any of our running backs have over 100 yards rushing? I doubt it. We hadn't had one go over 100 yards rushing yet. Maybe that'll change Saturday. But Georgia is going to have to play lights out on both sides of the ball. We definitely got to get pressure to Hendon Hooker and make him make mistakes. We need to get an interception or two. We need to recover a fumble, cause a fumble. Number one versus number two. I tell you, for a big-time Georgia fan, I am nervous about this game. And if you tell me that you ain't nervous about this game, I think you're wrong. This game right here makes me nervous. I am nervous now talking about this game. I will be nervous tomorrow before the game starts. I will be nervous from now until come 3:30 Saturday afternoon. Now, Georgia's defense really hadn't been getting pressure to quarterbacks all season. They did against South Carolina a little bit. They did against Florida a little bit. Can their defense get pressure to Hendon Hooker? We're going to find out Saturday. And I know I've had people, people's told me, well, Tennessee ain't got a good defense. Tennessee ain't got a good offense. They got one of the best receivers in college football right now in number 11. And it seems like to me, every team they've played, he's been a problem for their opponents. Our receivers are going to have to get open and catch the ball. How many drop balls did our receivers have against Florida? Wide open. And I know a part of that falls on Stetson Bennett because he either threw the ball too far away from him or he overthrew him, and that's what I said and meant. Stetson Bennett has to be smart with the football. He is going to have to get the football to these receivers to catch. And Ladd McConkey, maybe it's time for him to be on the bench and put another receiver in there because he really hadn't impressed me the last few games, especially in punt returns. And this game, he's definitely going to have to be on his A game and make sure he holds on to the ball. And let's hope Todd Monken calls an excellent game Saturday for Georgia to take down Tennessee. And like I said, this is all or nothing for Georgia. The season will be over if Georgia loses this game Saturday against Tennessee. Our offensive line has to contain their defensive line. Definitely got to hold up against their defensive line. And our defensive line needs to run over their offensive line. Georgia needs to control both lines of scrimmage. All game, period. I appreciate y'all watching my video. Be sure to hit that like, subscribe, share, and that thumbs up, guys. I sure appreciate it. And like always, win, lose, or tie, I'm a dog fan to the day I die. Go Dawgs!